Hello, everyone. This is Rev Paul with Miracles One, and welcome to another episode of Insights on A Course in Miracles. Over the past week, we worked on lessons 318 through 324, and contained within that group was another What Is reading, and it was titled What Is Creation? So what is creation as Jesus explains it? Jesus is explaining creation as we have God the creator, God that is love, and the creator of all that is, right? And the only thing that God really does is create more love, all right? And extend. He extends his love, and his love is creative, and as a part of that creative process, he created us as the holy Son of God. And if you think about the core of your being as being this wonderful radiant light that is all loving, that is infinite and all powerful, because it is an extension of God the Creator's love to us, and He created us exactly like Himself in all aspects, and we have been imbued with the same loving will to continue to create or extend love. This idea of extending love is the creation concept, as Jesus explains it to us. And that's all that we really do in heaven, is we receive continuous love from God that will never end. It has never not existed, and it will never fail to exist. It is infinite. There is no such thing as time, because it just is. It always was, and it always will be. And we have been created as perfect beings, and because we are so happy and joyful as these perfect beings of God, we turn it around and continue to extend creation. And by creating more love, more creative beings like ourselves, and it just goes on and on and on. And it's this process that is unimaginable here within the human body, within the world, within the dream. There's no way we can imagine what it's like. However, we can get glimpses of ourselves as these creative beings of light by going within and connecting with the Holy Spirit and allowing Him to give us glimpses of that inner light. And when you get those flashes and glimpses of that inner light, you will inherently recognize, oh, this is a glimpse. This is a part of who I am. And you may not fully realize it, but you'll kind of get it. You'll be like, wow, this is inside of me. And you'll feel it. You'll feel that love kind of shining through for a moment. And you'll also have this recognition that this same loving light, this creative light that's inside of you, is also inside of everyone else. And you just understand that. And that brings a smile to your face. That brings joy to your heart, because there's this recognition that all of this is not really real, that it really is a dream, which Jesus talks about over and over again. He says it seems to be a very real dream at times, but again, it's just only a dream, and it's going to vanish and dissolve away someday. Now, in this What is Creation reading in paragraph, it's number 11, I was looking at one of the later paragraphs here, and Jesus says here, we are creation. We, the sons and daughters of God, and He doesn't use the word daughters of God in there. I like to throw that in there just to be considerate of everyone. We seem to be discreet and unaware of our eternal unity with Him. So that's what's right now. I'm not aware that I'm, united with God, in that I'm eternal with him right now, because it's being blocked out by the body, the mind of the body, and this whole seeming physical experience. Yet, back of all our doubts, past all our fears, there still is certainty. For love remains with all its thoughts, its sureness being theirs. God's memory is in our holy minds, which know their oneness and their unity with their Creator. Let our function be only to let this memory return, only to let God's will be done on earth, only to be restored to sanity, and to be but as God created us. So we're having this temporary lapse of insanity to pretend that we're not perfect and that we're not like God, and we gave ourselves amnesia and we think we're living these lives in these physical bodies, and none of it is real. As I mentioned, it's going to dissolve and go away someday. And so there is this memory of God, our union with God, in our real state as we are with him right now in reality. It's hidden inside of us. It's hidden inside of our minds. And when we practice these lessons within the workbook for students, we begin to eventually have miracle experiences where the light will flash through and reveal itself to you. And I already talked to you about what it's like. There's also these miracle experiences where you'll begin to hear the voice of the Holy Spirit speak to you in a clear and audible voice, like I'm speaking to you right now. As a matter of fact, I was blessed with this experience earlier today when I was sleeping in the middle of the night around 2 or 3 a.m. I became aware that I was listening to this lovely female voice from heaven, and I take it that it was an angel, and this angel was singing a lovely song. And I could hear the words of the song in an audible female voice. And it was just so lovely. And I could tell this was coming from heaven. And this is a part of this experience of the voice for God that Jesus talks to us about. So I am so grateful for that gift. And I'm so grateful for having my experiences with the light so that I can share it with you, because it's going to help us all to awaken more quickly when we begin to realize this is what we're working towards. That's what these lessons are helping us to do. They're helping us to train our minds, to retrain our minds, to forgive and to let go, and to let go of all this garbage and this crap we've been taught over the years, and to free ourselves from that darkness. And as we free ourselves and become open and more relaxed, and we feel safer and we feel happier and more peaceful, then these miracle experiences not only begin to come through, they begin to come through more frequently, and they bless our lives more and more. And the miracle is extending love through us out into the world and blessing those around us. So this truly is a time of thanksgiving as we move into the week of Thanksgiving and prepare to share our gratitude and thanks. So make sure you spend time this week when you're in meditation and you're working the lessons to tell God, to tell Jesus and the Holy Spirit, thank you. Thank you for whatever, and thank them from your heart. And also take time to thank those in the physical world with you. I don't think I'm not necessarily in the habit of doing that all the time. And I think this is a great opportunity this week to practice this on a spiritual level, to extend our thanks to God for creating us, and knowing that even though we've taken a detour into fear here, into the dream for a little while, we are all going back home to heaven. And we are going to get there someday. We are already there now. And to feel grateful for that, that this is only a temporary lapse in the hell and insanity. All right. And while we're awakening from this dream with the help of the Holy Spirit and with Jesus and these miracle experiences, the dream becomes happier and more joyful for us while we're awakening. So there's gratitude we can express there. And then we can express gratitude to our brothers and sisters within the world, because the Holy Spirit often works through them to help us and bless us. And we allow the Holy Spirit to work through us to help and bless them. So it truly is a wonderful time to express that gratitude of thanks and to extend that love to others. So I wish you all a very wonderful Thanksgiving this year, and we'll see you again real soon. Bye-bye.
For more A Course in Miracles video teachings, our study groups, podcasts, self-study courses, articles, and personal A Course in Miracles coaching, access our website at miraclesone.org.